Welcome back to Bernard Koster. JR here, Mr. Marky Mark joining us. And we have another special guest here returning. He's too famous for us, but here he is again, Zachary Walker. Welcome back to the show, man.
Thank you.
Hey, man. He's famous, bro.
We've always knew that something was about to happen, and it was just a matter of time. And see, and hard work pays off. I've always told people when it was mentioned, like, hey, we've always known Zach has been, you know, working on his game ever since we met him and we saw his videos.
Right.
So maybe a quick question for you, Zach, like playing in the Raptors Arena. Is that your first time playing, or have you played at it before?
Yeah, it's my first time. It was a good experience. It's a lot of fun.
How did you feel before coming into the game, or before coming into Raptors Arena, watching the game? How did you feel about having a chance to play on an actual NBA court?
It's excited, nervous, because I've never played on that. But like, there's like so many people watching you, so you don't know what you're gonna do and all that.
Mm-hmm. And thoughts about the whole game you guys played during halftime. What did you think about the game you guys played?
It's good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's not really much to say, but it was really, really fun to watch and play. It was like good experience of like just seeing them, like just watching. It was fun, like to play on the court. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And well, let's get to the bottom of it.
Yeah, why not?
The move that you did, what inspired? Like, you know, is that your go-to move? Or is that something that you just kind of spurred out of, you know, the moment that you felt like, oh, that was the move I wanted to do at the moment of the game?
Yeah, it was a spur at a moment, like just threw out a random move, him, see if he would bite at it. Mm. He didn't, so I just pulled it out and it was like, oh, well, like I actually like did the move. Mm-hmm. It was just out of the random.
You haven't practiced that move at all, or it just came out of nowhere?
Yeah, I practiced it like lots of times, but it just out of my mind. I was like, I'm gonna pull this move out.
Did you ever think that move that you were gonna pull was everyone was gonna be watching it everywhere around the world?
No, I thought it was just gonna be a simple like my post on my Instagram. I never thought all of those big things were post my thing.
Mm-hmm. Then what are your thoughts then when you? I mean, when did you saw the first video and that the NBA Instagram posted? Like, when did you saw it, during the game or a little bit after?
When we got back up to our seats, we were just watching it, and my brother pulled out his phone and he said, "Slam Online just posted your video." So my brother freaked out. Me and my other teammate Bernard freaked out. We're like, "Whoa, this is like a big thing." Mm-hmm. And then a couple of seconds later, like a whole bunch of other things posted it. It was like good. It was like I felt good. Mm-hmm. Like all those people just posted my things. Like, yeah, it was like fun. Like, mm-hmm. I never knew like they would actually post my stuff and that.
Yeah, I know. I was watching the game. Mark, you probably were watching the game as well.
Mm-hmm. I think you were the one that sent me the video. I'm like, oh, hey, it's Zach.
I'm like, oh my God, it's Zach, man. Like, what is he doing on the Raptors Instagram for, man? You were reposted on House of Highlights, which is owned by Bleacher Report, Slam Online, as you said. You're all over Twitter,
the NBA.
Raptors, even NBA reposted you. But there was someone that I think was special to you.
A couple. Yes. We can start with,
First was Flay. Flay reposted you and actually did a video about you. So what are your thoughts on Flay actually doing a cover on you?
Yeah, lots of kids watch him usually. But like, I never seen, like, pictured myself being on Flay and all of that. So it was like a big thing to be on his, like, Instagram, especially. Like, it's sort of like dream come true for him and a lot of other things.
Mm-hmm. What were your thoughts when you were reading people's comments on your video and the videos that they reposted? Like, you know, did you ever look at some of the comments? Like, how did you feel when you were reading through the comments?
Like, every time I saw a good comment, like, I feel good about myself. Mm-hmm. Like, I just did something big. Like, I feel good inside. I'm like, okay, yes, like, I did it. Like, I did, like, that was, like, my first big thing. And I was like, yes, okay, time to move on to, like, other stuff. Mm-hmm.
You probably amassed a bunch of followers. Is there any people that come and message you directly and gave you, like, you know, some really good encouragement?
Steph Curry. Steph Curry?
Yeah.
Wait, so, the Steph Curry?
Yeah.
The Steph Curry. Wow. I mean, he's my favorite player. Like, I would have, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, we saw your reaction video. How did it feel when you, the moment you have that, you know, the follow and then the direct message? What was going through your mind? What was going through your whole body?
As you guys saw, like, I was shaking. Mm-hmm. I was like crying so much. Like, if you were me, you tears were all over my shirt. Mm-hmm. Like, it was like, it felt like an ocean was on me. Like, it was so much tears. And then next thing you know, while my brother was like videotaping me. Mm-hmm. Like he, like a message popped down and it's like, Steph Curry just sent you a message. And then he told me like, he sent you a message, right? Mm-hmm. And as I did not believe him at first because he usually plays around with me. Mm-hmm. But and then I actually checked it on his phone.
Yeah.
And it was like big, like mm-hmm. he actually like sent me a message.
Did you respond to him? Did you say anything
yeah.
back?
I said, look up to you. Thank mm-hmm. you very much.
Did wow. he say anything back after that?
No.
Oh, he's injured, so he's probably still recovering.
Yeah. Recovery.
What does it mean to you? I know, you're young. You going viral this young and also getting noticed by Steph Curry himself and even noticed by a lot of NBA people around.
It's a big, big thing for me. Like, I never knew that I could, I thought I would just be like, just work my way up to that. But like, it's 10 years old. Like, I never knew like at 10 years old, like I could do that mm-hmm. and like be big like that. Mm-hmm. It's usually the only like top players mm-hmm. like they usually get that like kind of supportness
mm-hmm. and I've seen you, like, you know, I've followed you ever since I've seen the work that you put on, so for me it wasn't surprising when you're able to do the move.
Yeah.
But to you, how did it feel to you to be able to, you know, to see that your hard work is paying off, that people are recognizing that your hard, you know, I think most people that just found you out overnight, they never saw the work that you put in back, you know, a year or two that you've been practicing and working on your handles. How does it feel for you to see that your hard work is finally paying off?
It's good because one of my teammates' dad said, if you want more of that, mm-hmm. you have to work hard. If mm-hmm. I don't work hard, I'm not gonna get that. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna get noticed by other people. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm just gonna like say, he said I was right here. But mm-hmm. if I keep on working, I'm gonna keep on going. But mm-hmm. if I don't, I'm gonna keep like decrease.
Mm-hmm. That's a really good, you know. I mean, yeah. we've seen you and like we've seen how humble you are, and it's good to see that it's not going over your head and that you continue to working hard after this. I mean, for not just that, but now that you have kids that are inspiring to, you know, to you, how does, you know, what are some of the advice that you want to give with kids now that are following you and are looking up to you because of what you were able to do on the court and what you were able to achieve overnight?
If you just work hard, you'll mm-hmm. success. But mm-hmm. if you don't wanna There's two different choices. If you want to play basketball for fun mm-hmm. or if you want to be competitive. Mm-hmm. Like, if you choose competitive, you actually have to keep on going. Like, you train from one, you wake up before school. Mm-hmm. And then when you go to school, you do good. And when you're done, you have practice, blah, blah, blah. And then you have, like, training and that. So, yeah, if you just want to be good in that, you just keep putting in the time and the work.
Mm-hmm. So what's next for you? Are you going to take advantage of this, you know, whole situation, you know, post some more videos or keep grinding in basketball? What's next for you?
I'm going to keep grinding so I can get more of this. Mm-hmm. I don't want it to stop. So mm-hmm. when they know me at 10, they'll know me at 18, 19, mm-hmm.
okay.
20.
Yeah, so well, they know you now, man.
Kids up there. Zach, he put in the work, guys. So whatever his advice is, if you're 10 years old, less than 10 years old, 11, 12 years old, you know what to do. Put in the work. Treat it like it's your life. Basketball can do a lot of things for you. That's what Zach has done. And yeah. we're just amazed to see. We've seen you a year. We've had you at a show once or twice already. So for us, we knew that, you know, it was just something was just about to happen. And then it's just a matter of time. And here it was.
And Zach's not going to be the only kid. There's going to be a lot of other kids out there, you know, going to be one day be in the NBA. Zach's going to probably be in the NBA. There's a lot of other kids. A lot of Canadian kids will be in the NBA. So hopefully we'll see you guys there and work hard. As always, playing basketball and also, you know, keep in mind, you got to take in school as well. But basketball is a great sport, you know, keep working at it. Anyways, thank you, Zach, for joining us again. Appreciate you coming on,
man.
Thank
you for having me.